Hello, everybody. Welcome to Drawing with Woodsy. My name is Michael Woodside, and I'm an animator who's going to teach you how to draw the Beast today. And he is appropriately named. It's a lot of lines to draw, so let's just go ahead and get started. I'm going to start off by cleaning my hands off with a sanitizer. Our pencils are sitting in the art drawer or the art bucket for a long time, so we just want to clean our hands before we get started, especially now as we're nearing the end, hopefully, of this COVID situation. Just want to be extra safe. So I clean off my hands and let's just get started warming up because it's going to take everything we've got to draw today. So I'm going to start with this red pencil. That'll be my underdrawing pencil. And then I'll go over later with a darker pencil, this black one. And I also have a blue here to color in the beast's eyes. So if you want to have a blue handy, that'll be good too. So first things first, we're going to start with some circles up here in the corner of the sheet of paper. And the beast is going to take up most of our page. So you see I've turned the page sideways. Normally we draw the other direction, but this is going to give us a lot of room to draw him and make sure that you can see everything. So when I do these circles, I'm just keeping them way off in the corner. These aren't for anything, just other than our warm-up abilities. So you can see I'm moving my whole arm as I draw these, and I'm not just moving my wrist or my fingers. You can get really small circles that way, or wobbly big ones if you do that. But if you animators really draw with their whole arm, you're tired at the end of the day. So this is good too because the beast is going to be difficult to draw, but I feel like we've had all week to warm up, so it should be good. And don't throw your drawing away in the middle if you think it looks weird. I promise you, I've drawn a lot of weird beasts in order to get ready for this drawing today. So hopefully I've broken it down into simple shapes that you can follow along with. All right, and I'll show you why we're drawing rough with the red, and we can go over with this black. Once we do that, if you haven't seen these drawings before, let's pick this line. We can just outline the ones that we want to keep, and then that will help us differentiate the scratchy drawing lines from the ones that we want the viewer to see. And then once we start shading things in, then it really all goes away. If you look at an animator's drawing, especially of a beast, they're really kind of sloppy drawings because the animators are finding it roughly. So if you don't know, the animator on the beast is Glenn Keane, and he has really expressive drawings, and they're always really loose and free. So if you want to search for the beast animation drawings online, just search Beast Glenn Keane, K-E-A-N-E, and look at how expressive those drawings are. So let's get started. First things first, we always start with our circle. And I'm gonna put my circle here at the top of the page, leaving a little bit of room on top, but a lot of room on bottom. And I want some room on the right and the left too, because his face is pretty wide down at the bottom, so we wanna leave space for that. So I'm just gonna draw my circle like this. And it's really rough and loose here. You can see I'm actually drawing with the side of the pencil here too. That creates a thicker line. And it helps me not press down too hard so that I don't commit too early to that kind of circle when it could just be like this. Hold into it, sharpen my pencil again. Okay, so the beast is gonna be looking straight at us. It's the simplest way for us to teach these shapes. So I have this ping pong ball here that I've drawn these lines on, and you can see that as I turn it to the side, you can sort of infer that the character might be looking this direction or that direction. But for the beast, just for simplicity's sake, we're going to be looking right at us. So I'm going to draw the vertical line straight up and down. It's going to go down pretty far past where the circle is because we're going to draw more shapes. And then the horizontal line will go right below the middle. So let's do the vertical line first. I'm gonna go all the way down, leave ourselves plenty of room. And then the horizontal line, I'm gonna go right below center, like that. Okay, we did it. You're doing great. So now let's go ahead and start on the whole head shape. I wanna build that in early so that we can just fit all the pieces within. So, to do that, we're actually gonna draw a diagonal line that goes out to the side here. Same on the other side. Okay, and then about the same length of the circle down here, just roughly, I'm gonna put a line there. We're gonna draw a little rounded shape. As best you can, you wanna have it equal on both sides. And then coming to the top, we're just gonna go connect that line up and then round it out to a point here. And if you look closely, you might notice that to draw the beast, start with a bell. Okay, it's in his design, he was meant for her. Okay, that is, if you believe it, the beginning of the beast. So let's go ahead and draw the nose. So the nose, there's a lot of interesting, complicated shapes for the beast that I'm gonna try to break down pretty slowly. So the nose, we're gonna start here on this line. I'm just gonna draw kind of a line that goes up this direction and then comes back more towards the middle. So it's almost straight on both sides. And then it meets up here in a point. It's almost like a little tunnel. You can think about cars going into this. But of course it sticks out, it doesn't go in. And then now for the bottom part of the nose, we're just gonna draw, bring it back up towards the middle. And it's not the same, there's more room on top than there is on the bottom. So you see these little extra corners, there's here, then there's a little corner there and a corner here, just to give them some structure. Okay, now coming off from the side here, we're gonna draw the actual part of the nose that has the nostrils. So these rounded lines that come down, just little ones. You're doing great so far, I promise. Okay, now we're gonna connect them with like a really soft V. So there's not really a point in the middle here, it just kind of rounds out and connects. You're doing it. Let's go ahead and draw the center of the nose. It's just going to make a really soft V again. And we're gonna draw his little nostrils. So it's the letter D on this side. And then on this side, backwards letter D. And we can just connect the outside into that. Okay, you're doing it, and I'm proud of you. This is a kooky little drawing, so, but we've had all week to warm up for it, so I feel like you got it. Okay, we got some easy lines here. Let's do the easy lines. So we're gonna draw basically a little lightning bolt. It starts at the corner here. Goes down and then up and then back down again. See a little lightning bolt, kind of like a sharp S turned on its side. Same on the other side. Cool. Let's draw the top lip. So we're just gonna bring right from the last little lightning bolt bend. Just draw a straight line down below the circle. Not too far below the circle. Same on the other side. And then we can connect them so it's not totally round. There's a little bit of a corner there. Music makes it feel like this is going really well. This is the instrumental for a place called Slaughter Race from Wreck-It Ralph 2. You got it, you're doing great. Let's draw the bottom of the mouth. So coming from here, I'm just gonna draw another sharp diagonal line. Same on the other side. And then close it off with a horizontal line. So it's pretty similar to that shape, it's just a little stretched out. I think while we're here, we're gonna draw these teeth. So earlier this week, we drew the Ongis from Raya and the Last Dragon. We talked about how that was a mixture of two different animals, right? It was a fish and a monkey mixed together. The beast is so many different kinds of animals mixed together. And right now we're drawing the teeth of a boar. Basically this whole nose, mouth area is like a boar, like a big pig. Remember Pumbaa? Those are these little teeth. If you want, you can have them stick outside of here. You don't have to. That just shows how big they are. And then now we can draw more lightning bolts in the middle of the mouth for where the teeth go. So I just draw them like this. Kind of like the letter W stretched out. And you can continue that over here just to show that they continue to wrap around the tooth. Little fangs. Okay, I think we're almost done with the mouth. To finish it, we want to draw this bottom lip. So I'm going to start with a little curved line down here that curves away from the lip. He's got a really thick lip, so we want to make sure we have room for that. And then coming from the side here, just like we came from the side here, I'm going to branch off and go out to the left. And then I'm just going to round it off and connect it here. Same on the other side. Okay, now let's go ahead and just draw. He's got a chin. Sticks out below the bell. So we're just gonna softly mark that in. So I did this little upside down V that's again soft here at the center. We're actually not even gonna see this part. And then it comes down to a point. So I just round out and then meet down here at the center line. And there's all these hairs down here, so we can just softly do that. So again, I said we're not gonna see this middle part because it just connects into the lip. So I'm just going to darken the areas that we will see. Goes out this way. And then this part actually kind of tucks in behind the lip too, so we can just connect that around. So the animators who animated on the beast would never draw him this way for the film because they were so used to drawing him. They have a shorthand for it, where they just draw real quick lines to help indicate what they mean and then build detail on once they're happy with it. But we're just gonna start with the detail. And once you get familiar with all of these detail lines, you can draw them much faster. And that's true for any character that we draw. So it just takes practice and time. People who animated and drew the beast probably drew him 100,000 times in order to get him into the movie. So that's a lot of practice. And those are just the drawings that made it into the movie. So let's go ahead and start with the eyeballs now that we've kind of figured out the whole mouth area. So right, thinking about this as the center of the eyes, we're just going to draw these ovals. So if you haven't drawn an oval before, think about a circle that's been squashed. So if this is a circle and someone sat on it, it turns into that. Sounds. Same on the other side. So his eyes are not just floating there, they're in the middle of what we call an eye mask, which is a whole big shape that kind of encloses that area. So to start that shape, I'm just gonna draw kind of a broken line right there, and then another broken line right there, and it breaks pointing towards the middle. Remember this lightning bolt that we drew over here? We're gonna draw a similar one. Comes out. And it's in a much longer line right here. And the last one is just a little baby line that ends up at the circle. Do it again. Longer. Let's give you a second to take a look at that. This is one of the hardest ones we've ever done, so don't feel like you should be doing better. We're gonna get there. Don't give up. I promise you, if you wait at the end of this, your drawing is gonna be much better than you thought it was gonna be right now. I know how you feel. But I had to draw him over and over and over again to learn how to do this for you. And I feel like every time I did, the drawing was much better at the end than I thought it was going to be halfway through. And you're thinking you're a professional, but even professionals are temperamental about their drawings, so it's not any easier. We just practice more. So part of what we're drawing here is the eye mask kind of actually continues down the face, and these are areas that we're going to shade in eventually, but don't do them yet because he's got a very interesting shading design. Okay, so let's draw kind of the start of the eyebrows. So starting where we drew this broken line, we're gonna draw another kind of rounded line that goes up and then out to the end of the circle. Same on the other side. And then where that line ended, and it tells us where to draw the next line. So what's nice about the beast, even though he's hard to draw, is that all these lines are sort of connected to each other. So it gives you a landmark of how do you get from one line to the next. So if you just take it one line, one section at a time, you can figure it out. Okay, so where we ended over here, I'm just gonna draw like a little rounded line this way. It cuts towards the eye. It's a C shape. We talked about the different lines that we use, which are C shapes, backwards C, S, backwards S, straight lines. And combination of all those shapes really helps you figure out how to draw a lot of things. So practice those. This is a great spot on your page to practice lines. Okay, so now we're just gonna roughly draw the shape. Eventually there's gonna be little hairs coming off of here, so don't go too dark with it. But basically it just goes out towards the bell and then pinches in right where we ended this other line. So out towards the bell. Okay. So before we do the hair details, I want to finish all the main shapes, and the next main shape is the brow. So we talked about how the beast is a lot of different animals, and one of the animals that was used as inspiration was a gorilla. And gorillas have these really strong eyebrows, so we're just gonna draw those here. So I'll do that one real quick just to talk about what it looks like before we draw the other one. So it's a little rounded J that comes up towards the top. On this side, it's a backwards J. And then this next line, we're sort of following the same pattern here. And then we just connect it into another J behind here. J. So starting from still outside of this top part of the bell, I'm just gonna draw a little rounded line. It's like a little bump. So if you were to draw a gorilla, their eyebrows kind of stick out like this. So that's sort of the area here that Glenn Keane, when he was designing the beast, took from a gorilla. It's a great shape. And then we just finish off this point. Whew, so many lines. Okay, let's draw these little ears. So the ears, Glenn Keane, when he was designing the beast, again, was like trying to find things that could soften him because there are all these kind of aggressive shapes with the teeth and this sharp nose. So I gave him the ears of a cow. So if you've drawn Sven before, he has pretty similar ears where it's, think about it like one droopy line that comes out this way and then another rounded line that brings it back. The same on the other side. Okay. Now we were talking about these stretched out S shapes. This is the time we want to use one of them. So of a backwards S. It connects, it would connect back here, but we can't see it because it's behind the brow. Same on this side. And if you're not good at drawing backwards S shapes, but you need one, you can always turn your page upside down and do a regular S shape. Okay, so he has these horns. I don't really know what animal these horns are from, but they look familiar. So we're gonna start right here on the side of the brow. And I'm just gonna draw a little rounded line up, and then another one up towards the top. Just start slow. It's kind of a weird shape, so we're gonna break it down piece by piece. So once you have this line here, we're just gonna bring it right back in. And now, a shape we all understand, upside down V. And when I drew this V, I drew one straight and then one kind of curved. Straight and then curved. Again, this side of your sheet of paper is really helpful to practice a line if you're not sure how to draw it yet. So I love seeing when people show their drawings, all of their scratchy test lines over here, because drawing is thinking, and this really helps think about what you're going to be drawing next. So now we just need to connect this back in. So from the bottom of that V, I'm just going to bring it up again towards the top, and then kind of a rounded line that just connects back to our original line. So that's almost done, but we just need to connect it to the head. So halfway down this line that we drew from that V, I'm just going to draw a straight line back down to the brow. A weird shape, but now that you've done it, let's do it again. Bring it this way. So for these videos, I like to go slow just to make sure that everyone gets a chance to catch up. V. Bring it back up. Rounded line that connects back into it. Weird shape. And halfway up this line again. We'll go here. Okay. We have the little simple detail lines we can add here because I feel like we need a win after this one. These are hard shapes. So from the top of our gorilla brow, not this part, but the little bump that we added here, we're just going to draw little lines that go up to the top of our bell. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. Let's draw these little hairs. These are fun. So remember these straight line, curve line? We're going to do that again. A straight line, curve line, coming off of this little swoop that we drew towards the eye that came out. And then straight line, curve line. And let's do this time, curve line, straight line. So hairs are kind of random and you can draw them really quickly too, really rough. That way they can feel more free like hair is, especially this guy. Now that we have practice with these, we can start filling in the side of the head here. So it's got longer hairs in the back here. In terms of other animals he was designed after, he's got the mane of a lion. You can only see part of it here, this angle, but you can really see it in the actual animated film. So there are no hard and fast rules for how many hairs, so I just keep this soft just by adding a couple lines. So if the line that we drew the bell is like this, I just try to draw lines that sort of feel like they're following that. So this is the bell. We wouldn't want it to be like this. It's following the flow of it this direction. He's got a couple layers of hair, so just inside the shape we're just going to draw a couple more hairs like that. We're almost done. We haven't done the eyes. So they're not totally open like this. He is smiling, so his cheek is being pushed up, so we're going to cut off the bottom like this. Just a little rounded line. You can draw it straight if you like. For all of the different animals that were referenced for the beast, the most important is not an animal. It is sort of. He has the eyes of the prince, right? The prince is in here. He's just sort of trapped in this beast form. So Glenn Keane and the animation team worked hard to maintain the human quality of the eyeballs. So they're kind of like how you would draw any kind of person's eye. So he has a little eyelid here. I just draw that with a V. It's always soft. Give him little bags under his eyes. He's been a beast for a bit. He's tired. We're all tired. We're so close to it. Let's draw his irises. So we drew this oval. We're going to draw another oval inside here. Keep it closer to the center of the eye. Sorry, the center of the head. Sometimes if it gets too far out to the side, it can feel like his eyes aren't really pointed in any direction. And he has another smaller oval inside that. And a tiny little circle for the highlight. There's a soul in here, and that little highlight helps us see that he's a good guy. Whew. Okay. Little detail. details that we're going to add that are small, but rewarding. So we need, I think we all could use something like that right now. Just draw these little hairs on his chin. Part of the boar design for the nose into the mouth, he just has these hairs that kind of point back towards the head. So you just draw these with these V's like that. Rounded line, straight line, rounded line, straight line. You'll see it over and over again when you look for it. All right, friends, I think it's time to start darkening our character. So I'm going to start on the left side of the drawing. We're going to be shading a lot of him, so I want to make sure that I don't smudge it. I'm sure later I'll bring in a sheet of paper to block my hand from smudging because I can't help myself. But so when we're cleaning up the beast, I think, remember, everything on him is fluffy and it's covered in hair, so we don't have to be really precise with our lines, and if your lines are scratchy, it's probably a good thing. Remember when we drew the Augie earlier this week, had a similar quality. It's a hard character to draw, one of the most advanced, so I hope that you have seen it through to the end. Once you shade him in too, that's really where he comes to life. And this video is up online, so you can always come back and practice. And Glenn Keane, who animated the beast, also has a ton of videos online drawing the beast, so it's great to watch him draw because he draws so quick and with so much confidence, and it's not like an accurate line-for-line drawing of the beast, but it feels so true to who the beast is because nobody knows better. His drawings are always really rough, but in a refreshing way, so hope you get a chance to check that out. Her hairs are soft. Fluffy. So many lines. Cleanup artists who are responsible for drawing the final lines that you see on screen, they call it line mileage. And you can see there's a lot of miles on the beast. So even the professionals who drew him in the film talk about how difficult he was to draw. So even if you finish this drawing, you're doing great. Cleanup artists who draw those drawings, they average usually about one drawing per hour. And that's 8 drawings in a day. When you think about Beauty and the Beast was animated at 24 drawings per second, the movie's about an hour and a half long. a lot of drawings. It takes a lot of time. So even though it goes by so fast, imagine your work just flying by. But the attention that they gave to the character really shows, like in all the work that they do. How the jobs are broken down. Animators are thinking about the performance of the character and the attitude and the acting and personality. And then the cleanup artists are thinking about the consistency on the screen to make sure that you can read all of the things that the animator wanted to do. So everyone's working together to make it happen. Saving the eyes for last. Center the eyes. So it really does take a whole group of people to see these things through, and that's just two departments. So many different people working on these films. If you ever stay through the credits, you just see so many names. So usually an animated film is being worked on for about 4 years, on average. Do the nose before it gets away from us. This happens right after I sharpen. Really scratchy with these lines. It's the hair on him, so we were got some freedom there. I just did all those teeth, which are not hairy, so spend a second to do that. More hair over here. Eventually this pencil tip will break. It's kind of scare me a little bit probably. Now I'm gonna need that buffer sheet of paper. Do these outlines that we did for the pour. All right, we're gonna start shading things in. So let's go ahead and start with these horns. We're gonna do kind of a medium tone. So you're not pushing all the way down. But it's not totally light. The lightest thing on him is gonna be some of the patches of his fur, obviously his teeth, eyeballs. So just wanna make sure we have a range. And then this is gonna be darker than that. And when I shade in, you can see I'm shading from the side of my pencil because it covers a little bit more ground more quickly. It's also smoother than if I were to shade it in with a tip of the pencil. So it might take some getting used to to hold the pencil this way, but good place to practice, you know where, over here. So about how dark that we did this, I want to do this part of the eye mask under the eyebrow. Make sure don't color in the eyeball. And it might be worth taking a breather and watching me color this in just to see, because there's a lot of shapes here. I might accidentally color in the wrong one. Or, you know, maybe it's just how you want to draw your beast. These first little hairs that we drew. Part of that. Let's do the other ear. Or the horn. Darker in here. A couple years ago, I got to see the Academy of Motion Pictures here in Los Angeles. They were screening an original print of Beauty and the Beast, a 70mm print, back from the original release in 1991. So it's crazy to be able to watch it in such high quality and film reel that was so well kept, 30 years or so. And they also had some people who worked on the film talking to panel afterwards. One of the cool things about living here in Los Angeles, and hopefully we can open up again soon, there's all sorts of film talks that happen all the time. And it costs $5 to go. I think that's all of those. So the next part I want to color in is the nose. It's going to be about as dark as these parts, the bottom part of the nose. Earlier I colored in the nostrils. Color in this top part a little bit lighter. Kind of a highlight there. All right, so the next part we're coloring in is the part of the biggest parts of him. So it's gonna start here at the top of the bell, and it's a really kind of a light tone. So this is our lightest tone so far. Stop at the nose. Get these little side pieces before we forget. sideburns, tops of the ears. All right, now these parts have the cheek area. If you made it to the end of this drawing, I am very proud of you, because it is a stressful drawing, I know. But we had all week to prepare, warm ourselves up for it. It's been a year since you started drawing with me, so hopefully it was easier than it would have been a year ago. And that's what drawing is, just to keep getting better and better. See how it's barely lighter than the teeth? Sorry, darker than the teeth. The chest, dark enough. And we're gonna do these side parts of the chin. And then using the same intensity, same lightness, we're gonna do these big pieces, the biggest ones. So get those in really loosely. Beauty and the Beast, when it was touring, the Broadway show was touring in Orlando. I saw it when I was a kid. And afterwards, I stood by the stage door where all the actors exit. You can get them to sign the program. And I saw, got to meet Belle and the Beast. And at the time, the actress who was playing Belle was married to the actor who was playing Gaston. So they walked away together, and I was like, wait a minute. Still a little bit of shading. And now we can do the lightest part that isn't white, so that the teeth and the eyes will still shine. So just even lighter than we just did it. The eyebrows, these little patches up here, just to make it just barely lighter than the other one. On the nose, and then this chin. One of the other animals that the Beast is formed after is a buffalo. Buffalo are really soft shapes, but they also have these really long beards, big chin. So Glenn Keane and team added that to the Beast. We didn't do the lip yet, so I'm just gonna do that kind of a slightly darker tone. Shading the teeth a little bit. Okay, we still gotta do these eyes. It's the last part of the Beast that Belle sees and recognizes the Beast in, so I wanted to make sure that we give those the attention they need. So I'm gonna color in the pupil. If you look at the movie, the outside of the iris, this outside color, doesn't have a black line around it, so we're gonna not use the black line. I'm just gonna color it in with my blue. So if you have a blue, now's the time to get it ready. Good thing about this being on YouTube as well is that you can pause it anywhere online, and that way you can catch up if you get a little bit behind. Got my blue. Let's do it. I'm coloring in everything except for that little white circle. he is. Don't forget to sign it. The Beast. So I hope you had a great time drawing with me this week. Remember, if you drew the Beast, hashtag drawing with Woodsy. That way I can see it and then you can share it with everyone online. You can also tag me in it at NMWoodsy on Twitter and Instagram. But I just wanted to say thank you for drawing with me this week. I had fun coming back to it and hopefully I can do it again in the future. But until then, remember, just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone. So thanks for spending time with me. Bye now.